Yo, what's going on YouTube? It's your boy Motion bringing you guys another video, guys. In today's video, we're going to bring you guys the best tips and tricks on how to maintain high ground. Now, maintaining high ground can benefit you in many ways, but as you guys can see, we are in theater mode right now. And the reason we're doing theater mode is because me and Arave got a decent gameplay. We got 13 kills each, but in this gameplay, I can actually focus and show you guys how you can get high ground and why I got high ground. Because in theater mode, if you guys didn't know, you can of course do all kinds of different things, like pause it, you can actually go backwards, go forward, you can slow it down, so I can break things down a lot better. And I can even go into a drone detach where I basically, or drone free, where I basically can control the drone completely and show you from a bird's eye view of why I did certain things and stuff like that. So I think the theater mode is really good when it comes to tips and tricks like that, you guys. So I actually want to start implementing more theater mode into the videos and stuff like that for you guys. When it comes to tips and tricks, you guys got to let me know by giving this video a thumbs up if you guys really want to see stuff like this. But let's continue with the video, and I really like it because we can fast forward like through all the boring parts. So basically, we're just gonna get all the boring parts out the way. So as you can see, there's somebody in this house. Automatically I know, hey, there's someone in this house, because I see that my teammate's not there and the roof is broken into. That means one or two things: somebody landed at that house and they broke in from the roof, and they're probably still in there looting because it is still super early game. So as you know, the first thing you want to do is get high ground. Instead of going in through the front door and just dying by a trap or something like that, you want to build up to the roof, get high ground on them. And you guys can see I heard him breaking something metal. If you guys go back a little bit, see, theater going back part is kind of gonna suck on console, but right here you're gonna be able to see, and I can hear it, you can hear it in the gameplay. He's starting to break something metal. Now, the only thing metal on this whole house, you got to think about things like this. The second you hear this right there, that first hit of him breaking metal, as you guys can see, if we go to drone free, he's down here in the garage breaking the garage door. You can see his little head right there peeking through there. So he's trying to break through the garage and trying to get me off guard. So I heard it and I was like, the only thing metal on this house is of course the garage door. So he's probably trying to break out. So the second I get on the roof, I notice it and I look behind me and I start gunning him down. I instantly knock him. Now the reason I'm gonna thirst him is because I saw he had a shotgun. I need a shotgun. I didn't get a shotgun in my house, and shotguns are huge, huge, huge in the start of the game. So instantly I was like, all right, I'm gonna thirst this guy, get his shotgun. And plus, and Rave needed weapons. I don't think he got any weapons in his house. So instantly I was like, all right, and Rave, I'm gonna drop you some weapons right here. I end up dropping him some weapons so he can actually win some games and stuff like that. So we're gonna fast forward through all this boring parts. Luckily, and Rave actually ended up finding a llama, as you guys can see. While he's looting the llama, I'm not even gonna go over there, because if you both hang out at the llama, if you find a llama and your whole squad is there hanging out at the llama, it's going to be extremely easy for you guys all to die. So instead, I let Rave go get the llama. He spotted it, let him get it, and then if he wants to share, most likely he will, he's gonna share the mask with me later on in the game by giving it to me later. As you guys can see here in a little bit, he's gonna end up giving me the mats right here. So he's splitting it evenly so that way it's actually fair and stuff like that. He actually gave me all brick, and I was like, just give me all brick, don't split it, just give me all the brick and I'll be good. And that happened. So we're gonna just again fast forward through all the boring parts because nobody wants to see it. Okay, so now we're in some action right here. So we saw people over here at the house that I hit. I saw that we're playing duos, of course, so I know there's gonna be two people here, and here comes his friend. I'm maintaining high ground, I'm building stairs. Now the reason you want to build these ramp stairs, let me show you guys real quick. So I see him across the map, I start putting some shots into him, and then he starts running. So okay, I was like, all right, I'm gonna challenge him, I'm gonna get aggressive, he's pretty weak. I saw I was hitting white shots, so I'm gonna do that. The second I see his teammate, instantly the first reaction is to build stairs. The reason you're doing this is it's not only to get high ground, but it's to protect yourself. As you can see, if this guy ended up looking at me, if he ended up looking at me extremely quick right here, if he ends up looking at me, you're gonna see that there's no chance that he can't shoot me. There's no way he can shoot me. He doesn't see me, doesn't have a line of sight. So if he did stop in the mid street trying to shoot me, he can't do it because I have my ramp blocking the way. Now as you guys can see, I could still see him through the ramp because it's still building, so I know exactly what he's doing, and then as I push up I can know exactly what to do. So it's a lot easier like that. You can see I'm actually hitting him. They're both super weak. So this other guy getting aggressive again, I'm building a ramp to give myself cover. The second I see somebody, you guys are gonna notice I build a ramp to give myself cover. I don't care if they're looking at me or not, it's just to protect myself, to be safe, so that way the second they do look at me, I have ramp, and also I have high ground advantage on the other person. Now right here is gonna be a one-on-one shotgun fight, and we're both on the floor just shotgunning each other, and then they both end up actually coming out to try and challenge me. And Rave is smart. See, and Rave pushed high ground, and because he got high ground, he didn't get focused, so he's free to just do whatever he wants. He has high ground, he's looking down at us all fighting, they're both focusing me, and as you can see, they knock me. But Enrave is here to clean it up, because they're pretty weak, because we all just got in a huge fight, and Enrave is just easily here with the high ground. The other dude's literally trying to thirst me, but Enrave came in clutch and actually saved me. So that's why you guys want to maintain high ground. If you're not doing it and you're up close fighting, make sure your teammate's doing it, you guys. Let's fast forward, because I don't think there's any kills for the next few minutes. Okay, right here, as I'm healing up, we hear people rushing me. I get the med kit off, and they're on the high ground, guys. They're on the roof, so I'm like, oh crap. These guys are on the roof. What am I gonna do? How am I gonna kill them? So I know that there's a hole in the roof, because this is the wall I broke down, so I was like, they can come in through this way. So let me watch the upstairs while Enrave has downstairs. So as you can see, I'm up here, third person peeking. Now, what I mean by third person peeking, I know a lot of you guys know this, but for those of you that don't know, as you can see, I can see him 100% clear, because I'm third person peeking. I'm hiding behind the wall, but I'm using the camera angle to be able to see him. Of course, I'm gonna show you guys real quick, just because some people don't know this, but as you can see, this person is right here and they can't see me. They have no clue that I'm there. She might have a little hint that I'm there, because she might have seen me for a split second, but she can't see me at all, so she doesn't know what I'm doing. She doesn't know if I dipped, if I stayed, or if I'm doing something else. So I can see exactly what she is doing, because I'm third person peeking, and once she takes a shot, I'm like, okay, the pump takes a while, so this is when I'm gonna actually pop out and take my shot, and then I hide again, because I know that she can take the pump shot again. So easily, once they take the pump shot, peek shoot hide, that's all you got to do. As you can see, I'm hiding, third person peeking again. I got some shots off on her. They're being smart, they're building high ground. I don't know exactly what they're doing out there, but I see that they're putting all these platforms down. They're above me and it's scary, so instantly I jump down. I was gonna actually take that ramp and go up, but I see her down here in the corner, so me and her end up getting in a gunfight. I knock her, and Enrave kills the other person. Now Enrave, what he was probably doing, I don't know exactly what he did, but we're gonna find out right now. What Enrave was probably doing was, Enrave got high ground. Now let me show you guys Enrave's point of view of this whole gunfight, because he probably did the right thing by just leaving and trying to get high ground on the whole fight. So we're gonna skip to Enrave's part. Now as you guys can see, Enrave, instantly, very smart play. Instead of just staying in the house and being scared, he's getting aggressive, he's getting high ground, he's making sure that he could actually get high ground on the person. So what he did was he automatically walked out, started building ramps, because he has these platforms above him, he's safe. He starts building ramps, gets the high ground, and as you're building ramps, the second you know that you're up a little bit higher, turn around and put these walls down, jump up, and put another stair ramp, and you can go even higher, which is exactly what he did. And as you can see here, Enrave has high ground. They're focusing me while Enrave gets high ground, which is really good, man. If one person's getting focused, get high ground. As you can see, Enrave is above him. He heard the other guy climbing. He could have easily took the shot on that guy, but Enrave didn't want to lose the high ground advantage. So instead of actually taking his time focusing that guy, he wanted to maintain high ground. He didn't want the other guy to get it, so he started building up because he thought the other guy was trying to climb up, and exactly is what he was doing. But the other guy, I think, choked. So as you can see, Enrave ended up maintaining high ground, and he's just getting even higher, so that way nobody can ever challenge him. All he has to do is look down at the person. And of course, as you can see here, he's looking down at him. High ground is not only good because you can see people and they can't see you, but look at this view that he has, you guys. Look at this view that high ground people get. Basically, what do you see on this person? You only see one thing, and that is his head, you guys. From the high ground, you have a easy shot at his head, so you're getting critical hits on their head and stuff like that. So guys, make sure you're getting high ground for things like that. He easily just looks out and shoots him from the high ground, gets a nice critical headshot damage, and kills him that way, you guys. So let's skip forward and try to get to another kill. All right, you guys, coming up, we're gonna see people right here. So as you can see, I'm building up because Enrave spotted people at blue house. He called out, they're on top of blue house. So instantly, what we're doing is we're building over there, and we're making sure that we maintain high ground. Now as you can see here, we're gonna go into a drone free landscape, and as you can see, the guy's down here building. I believe he's down here building because somebody had to put these walls up. Yeah, there he is, right there. He was building, and now he sees this. John Wick is actually smart. He sees that we're building up, we have high ground advantage, and what he's doing is he's like, okay, let me change my route. What he's probably gonna do is he's probably gonna come around back, climb up the back of the house, and get on the house to try and maintain high ground. But that's, I figured someone's gonna try to get on the house, so that's why you see me building up even higher. And Rave has high ground, and I have high ground as well. So if we come over here, I see him rotating around back, and I'm getting over here trying to cut him off. I'm basically going to try to cut him off as quick as I possibly can. And he actually didn't do what I thought he was going to do. And Enrave's in the fight. I'm not in the fight at all. So we're going to go to Enrave's point of view and see exactly how he handled this. So as you can see, Enrave, he sees him. He knows it. And Enrave's getting aggressive. I'm pushing above. I'm trying to maintain high ground. I'm getting as high as I can. Enrave's like, nope, I'm going to go into the house and get aggressive on these people. He sees this person destroy the wall. Instantly, shotguns that person. Has high ground advantage on them. Shotguns her. And again, he one pumped her because he had high ground. He basically hit her in the head, and the John Wick, it's a 1v1. GG's that easy. Enrave did the perfect thing right there. He had high ground, he saw they were breaking the wall down, and he exactly did what he needed to do. We're gonna fast forward to the next kill, you guys. Okay, right here, this is actually going to be a good build off. This is going to be a good example for you guys. We hear people coming. As you can see, we hear people building, and Rave calls it out. He's like, oh, there's people here. Instantly, first reaction was, okay, they're on the roof, because he heard people building. He knows there's people there. I got to get high ground. Of course, that's always the first thing you want to do. I got to make sure that I'm up and above, and I did exactly what I said last time. Build the ramps. Once you know you're at a certain height, turn around and put the walls down, jump and put the stairs down. That's exactly what all the pros do and everything like that. As you can see, I can see him. I have a little bit of a high ground slight advantage on him. And I decide, you know what, let me take the shot. Now, take the shot once, take the shot twice, and I did the same exact tactic that I told you guys earlier. You look up, shoot, get cover, look up, shoot, get cover. That's exactly what you guys want to do. And this guy's actually pushing high ground. See, this is where a situation where a lot of people actually get screwed in and they start to struggle. So basically, in a situation like this, this guy's about to get high ground, which is not good. So there's two options I could do. I could either, one, I can drop down to the floor and just give up and try to find a new route. That's a very good tactic, you guys. Finding a new route, giving up is not a bad thing. If you just know that, hey, this guy got high ground on me, there's nothing I can do, let me find a different route. Let me not pursue him in the way that he thinks I'm going to. Let me try to find another way around him. That's a smart thing to do. Or you can easily try to challenge him, try to get aggressive, and do exactly what I do here. I can't build stairs going up so easily. I put a flat platform down, and then I build stairs going up to the right. Instead of going in directly into him, because there's nothing you can do about that, I decide to build stairs to the right. And instantly, the second I have myself open and he could see me, instantly turn around, put up walls to protect myself. And as you can see, perfect timing, because the second I turned around and put up that wall, he took a shot. He could have hit me, but I put that wall up perfectly timed, and he did not hit me. So as you can see, as I'm jumping, I'm going to put stairs above and get high ground on him. Just that easy, you guys. So now you can see I have high ground, and what do I see? Nothing but a freaking head, you guys. I see nothing but a headshot, and that's why it's very good, because easily all you see is the head. Instant headshot, but I choked. I actually got really aggressive, and that's one thing that I need to work on, is as you can see in that situation right there, I got really aggressive, which I should not have. And what I mean by getting really aggressive is you can see here, I have the perfect shot. There's nothing. Actually, I think I was already jumping because I was already in the mindset of getting aggressive. But as you can see here, if I stayed on the ramp and just looked down at him and took the shot, I probably could have done a lot more damage. But I got aggressive and I jumped, trying to get aggressive and trying to get in his face to make things more challenging. And that's why I ended up choking my shot. I hit him, but not as much as I should have. Now, as you can see, he's trying to run away. Now we're in a serious on top of the build-off gunfight, you guys. I'm hitting him a few times, he's trying to hit me, and now he has high ground because I accidentally fell. Instantly, right when I fell, I see this platform is weak. Initial thought, I should have been like, okay, shoot the platform, make him fall down to my level and fight him that way. But I was literally sitting there scared, thinking, and this happens to everyone, you guys. I was literally sitting there, I froze up, and I was thinking, I was like, oh crap, what do I do if he has high ground? I need to make sure that he's not looking down, shooting at me. I know he's weak, so I'm just waiting for him to peek. The second he peeks, and then I realize, okay, I can shoot the flat platform. But he got lucky and built this, but I'm still looking up, trying to see it, and the other guy ends up shooting me. But as you guys can see, my boy Enrave went big. So we're going to go to Enrave's camera during this fight, because Enrave actually went pretty big, and he was helping me out. So as you can see, I don't know where Enrave actually went right here. I guess he went to go loot people while I was fighting, because I was in a fight with these people for a while. Right here, you can see that's when I got aggressive and I jumped down trying to fight him. And Rave's down here, and instantly Rave's like, okay, they're up there fighting. There's nothing I can do from down here. So his initial thought was, I got to get up there and help my boy out, and I got to actually get on the same level as them. Exactly what he did. He maintained high ground. He got up there, easily took the shot on this guy. He could have put up a wall and protected himself, but he instantly switched to his other shotgun, which is smart. You want to pump, tactical shotgun switch. Good play by Rave. Ends up knocking this guy and then challenges this other guy. Gets in his face. I don't know if he knew he was on the roof, but he was just trying to get aggressive because I told him, Rave, I'm weak. I'm like, yo, I'm weak. They're challenging me. They're about to knock me. So he got aggressive, and he got in the guy's face and just knocked him that way. So that was a good play by Rave. And you guys, that is basically how you maintain high ground. If you guys do like this series, this is only a part one. If you guys want to see part two, the rest of the gameplay, as you guys can see, we still have a whole half of the gameplay to do. I got to know in the comments below, in the likes below, give this video a thumbs up if you like these kind of tips, because we can really break it down, you guys. We can really go into drone free, drone attach and stuff like that, and we can do anything we want. And in serious gunfights, we can go ahead and watch it from out here. As you guys can see, we're gonna watch this whole fight play out from all the way out here. We're gonna watch the whole thing from all the way out here, so that way you guys can see exactly how everything happened and why people did certain things and everything like that. I believe I'm in this house looting this guy. Yeah, I'm right there looting this person. So we're gonna watch this from out here, and we're gonna see exactly how this works, you guys. So as you can see, they're getting on the roof. They're rushing up here. I hear them building. And Rave, I think in Rave, this is when Rave dipped out, and he was over here looting people. So I heard them building, and Rave didn't give a call out, but I heard them building, and I knew when Rave wasn't there. So I was like, okay, there's other people here. So instantly, I'm like, all right, let me get aggressive. I'm building up, taking shots off on them. The other dude got scared because I hit him, and he was like, oh, fuck this, I'm out. So he dipped out of there. The other dude, he's ready. He's challenging me, playing very smart, gets high ground on me, and I easily instantly counter it. The second I see him building up, I'm like, all right, I got to think quick and move quick. So I counter it as quick as possible, put up the wall, protect myself. Now I have high ground, shoot him a little bit. And as you can see, we're in a gunfight right there. And Rave's coming from the distance. He's over here lagging and whatnot. But the other dude ran away. Look, he's building. The other dude is shook, man. He's scared. He's over here building who knows what, because I put a few shots into him. He's scared. He's obviously a no-skin, so he's probably not that good at the game. And as you can see here, me and a Rave are over here fighting. This guy gets high ground on me. I'm just waiting. I'm waiting. And Rave comes in clutch, gets in a gunfight with him, and starts fighting him. And then Rave comes down and kills the other guy as well, you guys, which very clutch play. Again, if you guys want to see more tips and tricks like this, I don't see any other YouTuber doing it, but it'll probably start happening. Please give this video a thumbs up. I appreciate that more than anything, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.